Hello children, this video class is an initiative of Shivjyoti Educational Group. I am Shavya Vyas and I gladly welcome you to my social science class. Today we shall be doing chapter 13, local government agencies. So before I start with the chapter, I request all of you to open your textbook page 77, okay? Page 77, okay? The topics covered in this chapter would be, we shall learn what are local government agencies and Gram Panchayat, Municipal Council and Municipal Corporation. Now let's start with local government agencies. Okay. So India is a vast country. India is a vast country. And you have 28 states and 8 union territories. So India is a vast country with 28 states and 8 union territories, and in each state you will notice, you will find number of villages, towns and cities. So who takes care of the welfare of the country and union territories? You have your central government. So the central government takes care of the welfare of the whole country and the union territories, and you have your state government. State government taking care of the welfare of the respective states. But who will take care of the welfare of villages, towns and cities? There your local government agencies play an important role. So the local government agencies they take care of the welfare of villages, towns and cities. So in a upper level, the central government and state government take care of the welfare, and in the lower level, that is in the grassroots level, you will find the local government agencies playing an important role. Let us talk about the different roles that the local government agencies play. Role of local government agencies. So first role is to provide civic amenities. What are civic amenities? Civic amenities are facilities needed to make life easier and more pleasant. Like, what are the examples of civic amenities? You have your drinking water. You have your drinking water. You have your electricity. You have good roads. So these are the various civic amenities provided by the local government agencies. Okay. Now what they have other roles also. What are the other roles? That is, they try to involve the local citizens in determining द लोकल प्रॉब्लम्स. ठीक है, एवरी एरिया हैज देयर ओन डिफरेंट लोकल प्रॉब्लम्स. सो व्हाट दे डू इज दे इन्वॉल्व द लोकल सिटीजंस देयर, दे डिटरमाइन व्हाट आर द लोकल प्रॉब्लम्स एंड इश्यूज एंड देन दे ट्राई टू सॉल्व देम. ओके, एंड देयर ऑल्सो अ कनेक्शन बिटवीन द सेंट्रल एंड स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड द लोकल पीपल. व्हाट हैपेंस इज आवर गवर्नमेंट they provide lot of schemes and facilities for the local people, but since local people are not very much aware, these local government agencies, they are like a mediator between the government and the local people. What the government provides for the local people, they pass it on to the local people and things are implemented much easier. Okay, now let's come to the different types of local government agencies. Local government agencies, okay, they are classified into first is your Gram Panchayat. Second is your municipal council. And third is your municipal corporation. So, Gram Panchayat takes care of the problems and issues of villages. Okay? So, if you are in a village, who will take care of your problems? The Gram Panchayat will take care of your problems. And Municipal Council, they cover all the towns and small cities. Which are the small cities that you know? Okay, they cover towns and small cities, and municipal corporation, they handle issues of big cities. Okay, now let's talk about examples of villages. You have Sangod and Sultanpur. These are some of the names of villages in Kota. So here you have Sangod Gram Panchayat and Sultanpur Gram Panchayat. And now let's talk of small cities. Which are the small cities? You have cities like Alwar and Tonk. Okay. So, you have Municipal Council of Alwar and Municipal Council of Tonk. And now let's talk of big cities. You have Kota, okay? Kota, Jaipur, Jodhpur, these are all big cities in Rajasthan. And there you can find Municipal Corporation, and in local language it is called Kota Nagar Nigam. And in Kota you have two municipal corporations. You have Kota Nagar Nigam North and Kota Nagar Nigam South. Okay, now let's come to the next topic, that is Gram Panchayat. Gram Panchayat. Okay, the people of the village who are 18 years and above, okay? So 18 years and above, that means you are eligible to vote, okay? So these people, they gather together and make up the Gram Sabha. So members of the village who are 18 years and above and are eligible to vote, they form the Gram Sabha. Okay. And these members of the Gram Sabha, they elect and choose members of the Gram Panchayat. So, Gram Sabha people, they elect or choose members of the Gram Panchayat. And these members of the Gram Panchayat, they elect the head called, and the head of Gram Panchayat is called Pradhan or Sarpanch. And there is a rule that in every Gram Panchayat there should be at least one woman member. So, making a rule that there is at least one woman member in the Gram Panchayat is a way of strengthening the woman power in the villages to make the people aware that women are also powerful and are also informative and intelligent enough to take decisions related to the problems and issues in the village. Okay. Now let's come to, and what do these people in the Gram, members of Gram Panchayat do? They meet regularly. They meet regularly to discuss the various problems and issues that is happening in their village. And not just that, they, these meetings of Gram Panchayat, they are also useful in passing on latest information or advancements that the government has provided for the villages. Okay, so, and from where do the Gram Panchayat get their money from? They get their money from the government. Gram Panchayat get money from the government. So, government supports them in many ways by providing latest schemes, by providing ideas to the villagers and helping them in uplifting their lives. Okay. Now let's come to the main functions. Main functions of the Gram Panchayat. Okay. दबाए सर कुछ भी नहीं ये ओके नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस द वेरियस फंक्शंस ऑफ ग्राम पंचायत ठीक है फर्स्ट फंक्शन इज to provide safe drinking water to villages. As you know, these villages, especially the women and children, they have to travel to far away places to get water. So, what did they do? The Gram Panchayat, they got together and in their meetings, they identify the central spot where water can be provided. So, what are the various ways? They planted tube wells and where there are access to dams and canals, they also make plans to provide access to water and safe drinking water to the villagers. Now, let's come to the second point. to keep the villages clean. So what you the government has put forth Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, okay? So the Gram Panchayat had been very effectively implementing these schemes in the local villages. So like, for example, if you go to villages, I noticed there were many houses where Izzat Ghar was written. So all those houses where toilets were built in each and every house, there Izzat Ghar was written in bold red letters to encourage the villagers to build toilets in their own homes and to discourage them from going to toilets in public places in the open, okay? And they also built public toilets in different areas of the villages. And you also have waste collection system. Because of poor waste management, there were a lot of diseases spreading in the villages. So they, Gram Panchayat has been very effectively collecting waste and using them for recycling and compost. Okay, so what they do is, these people, they collect waste from individual houses in the villages, okay, and the waste is sorted out, and this correct usage of waste is called waste management. So what they do is, they segregate the waste into compost, rubbish and recycling. So compost is your organic waste, that is, it could be your fruit, skin, your vegetables, all the organic waste, they are collected to make compost. So what is compost? So all these organic waste, they are made to decompose further, okay, using earthworms and other items, and these are used as compost for these compost are very useful for farmers, okay? And products that can be recycled, for example, you have your paper, you have your plastics, these items can be recycled. So those items are recycled, and thus an effective waste management has been done in the villages. And in different places, they have put dustbins so that villagers develop the habit of throwing waste in the dustbin and not litter around. Now, let's come to third point, to build and maintain the village roads and street lights. So, if you notice now, when compared to the olden days, you find very well maintained roads in villages nowadays, and because of that, it's becoming very easy for the city dwellers to travel to villages, okay? The roads are good, the roads are well maintained, and the street lights are also well maintained, and these things happened mainly because of the effective functioning of Gram Panchayat. And the fourth function, to provide quality education to children and adults of the village, okay? So every children up to the age of 14, government has implemented a scheme of compulsory education, okay? So Gram Panchayat, because they are involved in the local level, they make sure that all the children, whether it is a girl child or a boy child, all the children, they receive compulsory education. And not just that, there are many illiterate people in villages. So because government has implemented schemes of adult education in villages, you can find many volunteers and qualified people going from village to village, educating and providing basic education even to adults. So what is an illiterate person? A person who cannot read and write, okay? So these in adult education scheme, people, they teach young women, old people, young men, everyone, anybody who doesn't know to read and write, they teach them to read and write. And the fifth point, to set up and run well-equipped health centers in the village to look after the sick. So Gram Panchayat, they make sure that the villages are well equipped with well established hospitals so that the villages need not travel far away to treat their sickness or accidents. Okay, so if you actually see, they can find well maintained dispensaries and clinics and hospitals there, and you also find mobile dispensaries not only for humans but also for animals. Like, you know, farmers are very dependent on animals and they support them in their agriculture. So a healthy animal is essential for a healthy farming. So not just for humans, government also provides various facilities to treat sick and injured animals also. And the sixth point, to improve the conditions of agriculture and small scale industries in the village. Okay, so what happens is, government has introduced various schemes for agriculture. So the Gram Panchayat communicates to the local villagers about the various agricultural schemes so that they can take advantage of these facilities and uplift their lives. Okay, and there are also small scale industries in the village. So Gram Panchayat, they give through the government, they give new ideas to develop their small scale industries. Like, you have your pottery, you have your weaving, you have your honey processing. So these are the various small scale industries that you find in the village. You can also find compost making there. So Gram Panchayat, they give them new ideas and they kind of provide mediate between the government and the villages to increase their income. And the seventh point, to help settle minor disputes between villages. Okay, so if you actually notice, you have your sarpanch, the head of the Gram Panchayat is here, and whenever, what is dispute? Disputes is nothing but quarrels or fight between villages. Let's say there was a dispute between two villages regarding the encroachment of land. So what does the head of Gram Panchayat, the sarpanch, do? He calls all the members of the Gram Panchayat, a meeting is held. He hears the problems of the villagers and he tries to find an amicable or a peaceful solution after discussing with the other members of the Gram Panchayat. So thus, the Gram Panchayat helps in settling minor disputes between villagers. So this completes Gram Panchayat. Let us now proceed to Municipal Council. Let us now go to Municipal Council. Like I said before, Municipal Council handles the welfare and problems of towns and small cities. Towns and small cities. For example, Alwar and Tonk. Okay, these are the examples of small cities. So, who elects the members of Municipal Council? Again, like in Gram Panchayat, any member who is 18 years or above. Of that particular area, they elect the members of the Municipal Council. Once the members are selected, what happens? They now elect the head of the Municipal Council. They elect the head of Municipal Council. Council. They elect the head of municipal council, and the elected head of municipal council is called chairman or chairperson. Chairman or chairperson. ठीक है, I repeat, municipal council handles the welfare of small towns and small cities, and people of that area who are 80 years or above, they can choose the members of the municipal council, and these members of the municipal council together they elect their head, and the head of municipal council is called chairperson or chairman. Okay, now let's come to municipal corporation. Municipal corporation. So now we come to municipal corporation. So what happens is, in big cities like Mumbai, Delhi, Kota, you will find these things are handled by, these things are not handled by municipal council, but it is handled by a bigger corporation called municipal corporation. And what is the head of municipal council called? Head of municipal corporation is called mayor. Head of municipal corporation is called mayor, and the main functions of municipal council are, now let us now discuss the main functions of a municipal council. So most of the functions are very similar to Gram Panchayat, but the main difference is Gram Panchayat handles the issues and problems of the village, and municipal council, it handles the problems and issues of towns or cities. Okay, so the first function is to keep the town or city clean by organizing collection and disposal of waste, and setting up public toilets. It's same as what we discussed in Gram Panchayat. Second function, to arrange for the supply of safe drinking water. So like you know, unlike the villages, you have number of people living in cities. Okay, so the more the number of people, the more the requirement of water. So government, they make sure by installing different water system in different areas, they make sure that everybody get access to enough water and as well as safe drinking water. And the third point, same as what we discussed in Gram Panchayat, to maintain street lights and roads. And the next function is to open and run primary health centers and hospitals, then to provide free and compulsory education for children up to 14 years of age. Even in cities, you will find many children who still do not go to school. And to protect such children, so what are these children used for? These children are used as child labor. Child labor is nothing but a small child working in houses and constructions and restaurants. So these children, they are misused, and instead of sending them to schools, they are made to work to earn money. So to protect these children, government has made compulsory educational scheme for children up to 14 years of age. So the people working in the municipal council, they look for children who are subject to such labor, they bring them out of that problem and they put them in school. Next function is to construct and maintain roads and parks. Like I said, you have plenty of roads in cities. They are to be well maintained because of the frequent usage. There is always probability of getting spoiled roads. So they make sure that they maintain the roads in their areas, and because in order to take some time out of the constant pollution that we are exposed to, government has encouraged the erection of number of parks to increase the green area of the cities. And next function is to organize literacy program for adults, just like what we discussed in Gram Panchayat. So these are the various functions of Gram Panchayat, and let us now talk about okay. So to carry out these functions, municipal council need a lot of money. So how do they get this money? Now let us talk about how municipal council gets money. Money to carry out these functions, a large amount of money is needed. Money comes from taxes that people pay. What are the different kinds of taxes that people pay? Taxes are paid for goods, for various services. Like you pay for water, you pay for electricity. Okay, you also pay taxes for the land that you live in, or the house that you live in. Okay, and you also pay taxes for the income that you receive. So these are the various taxes that people pay, and this tax amount is collected by the government and it is used for the various schemes and for the welfare of the people. Okay, that's why they say in order to become good citizens we must pay our taxes honestly and regularly. Why? Because the taxes that we pay, that is used for the welfare of the people around us, and it is also used for our welfare. So, and the state government also gives money to the municipal council for the various expenditures that they incur. Okay, so this concludes the explanation part of the chapter. Now we shall do the book work and copy work of this chapter. For that, I request you to open your textbook page 80 and we shall start with the exercises. The first exercise, that is exercise A, write T for true and F for false statements. Let's come to the first statement. The members of the Gram Panchayat are chosen by people who are 12 years and above. It is false. Why? Because it is chosen by people who are 18 years and above. Now let's come to the second part. Most of the money for the municipal corporation comes from the taxes we pay. That is true. Question 3. All villages have a municipal corporation. It is a false statement. All big cities have municipal corporation. Question 4. Every Gram Panchayat must have at least one woman member among its elected members. It is true. Question 5. The head of the municipal corporation is called the Sarpanch. It is false. The head of Gram Panchayat is called the Sarpanch and the head of municipal corporation is called the Mayor. Now let's come to fill in the blanks in the same page, that is page 18. Question 1. Civic amenities in villages are provided by the Gram Panchayat. Question 2. The Sarpanch is the head of the Gram Panchayat. Question 3. The Panchayat runs health centers to look after the sick. Question 4. Members of the municipal council are called municipal councillors. And question 5. The mayor is the head of the municipal corporation. Now let's come to multiple choice questions. Question 1. Civic amenities in a village are provided by who provides civic amenities in a village? It is provided by Gram Panchayat. Question 2. Most people in our country live in cities, villages, towns. So you have many people in our country living in villages. Question 3. The head of the municipal council is called the chairman. And question 4. Big cities like Delhi are looked after local government agencies called municipal corporation. So you have municipal corporation looking after big cities like Delhi. Okay. You have municipal council looking after small cities and towns like Alwar and Tong. And you have the Gram Panchayat looking after the villages like Sultanpur and Sangod. So this concludes the book work of this chapter. Let us proceed to the copy work. Okay. So before we start with the copy work, children, write your notes very neatly. Make sure to draw the red margins wherever it is necessary. So let's start with the red margin here. Write chapter 13 in the first line, underline that in red. In the next line, write local government agencies, underline this also in red. And in the next line, write define, underline this also in red. Now let's come to the first definition. First definition is citizen. Okay, underline this in red and write the definition. Who is a citizen? A person who has the right to live in a country is called a citizen. Now let's come to the next definition. Second definition is govern. What is govern? To control the public affairs of a country. Now let's come to answer the following. What is the first question? What are civic amenities? Answer is, don't forget to draw the red margin here and underline answer the following. Now let's come to question 1. What are civic amenities? Answer is, civic amenities are basic facilities to live a comfortable life. Example, water, road, etc. Now let's come to the next question. Draw a red line here, leave a line and come to question 2. Question 2, who chooses members of the Gram Panchayat? Answer is, the Gram Sabha chooses the members of the Gram Panchayat. After concluding the answer, draw a red line, leave a line and come to question 3. Question 3, list 4 important functions of the Gram Panchayat. Answer is, 4 important functions are 1. To provide safe drinking water. 2. To build and maintain roads. 3. To set up health centers. And 4. To build schools. So after the answer, draw a red line here. And let's proceed to the fourth question. Again, don't forget to draw the red margins in the new page. Write question 4. Write 2 functions of the municipal council. Answer 1. To keep the town or city clean. 2. To arrange for the supply of safe drinking water. After the answer, draw a red line and conclude the answer. So this concludes the explanation part, the book work and copy work of the chapter. I hope you have a great time studying this chapter. We shall meet again in the live class. Have a great day.